This is the changing landscape of India. State-of-the-art technology and environment-friendly habitats are changing the very contours of our geography. Indian real estate sector seems to have finally come of age. However, behind all that glitter of these changing landscapes, Cobra Post has uncovered a world of stealth and subterfuge. This is a world of mercenary agents at the helm and their covert practices well co-opted by those down the ladder. Cobra Post reporter Mohammad Hizbullah exposes these ninjas of the Indian real estate industry, and you are watching Operation Black Ninja. The case studies in this investigation demonstrate how most real estate companies in India have developed intricate mechanisms to ingest black money into their coffers. This black money trade is not a minor occurrence limited to half-literate brokers setting up shop in shady fly-by-night sheds. It is a meticulously organized crime that has the final seal of approval from the highest authorities of these real estate majors, and that the crime is rampant across the country. Operation Black Ninja covers 35 real estate majors in Delhi, Noida, Gurgaon, Ghaziabad, Mumbai, Hyderabad, Jaipur, Lucknow, Kolkata, Kochi, and Bengaluru. The investigation panned over 18 months, where more than 30 senior officials revealed their modus operandi to ingest black money into their companies. These include chairmen, managing directors, directors, CEOs, vice presidents, presidents, general managers, and several other senior officials. Following are the real estate majors that have come under the Cobra Post radar: Ajnara India Limited, Earth Infrastructures Limited, Mahagun Group, Pratik Group, Sarvottam Group, Lakhani Builders Private Limited, Lodha Group, Kanchal Group, Raheja Developers, Shalimar Corporation Limited, GeoWorks Realty Private Limited, Investors Forum India, SVP Builders India Limited, Rajput Properties and Developers Private Limited, International Land Developers Private Limited, Fortune Infra Developers Private Limited, Mangalam Build Developers Limited, Godavari Developers, Rudra Buildwell Projects Private Limited, Shri Group, Plus Projects Private Limited, RG Group, ABW Infrastructure Limited, Alpine Housing Development Corporation Limited, Antriksh Group, National Builders, OK Plus Builders and Developers, Janapriya Engineers Syndicate Private Limited, Barmatech, Archie's Projects Private Limited, Aston Realtors Private Limited, Vipgyor Housing Limited, Travancore Builders Private Limited, Vedic Realty Private Limited, and Concord Group. You are watching Operation Black Ninja. Cobra Post reporter Mohammad Hizbullah sometimes poses as a frontman to a fictitious South Indian politician, and at other times, a fixer for a non-resident Indian miner. He makes his way to the senior management of various real estate companies through their respective brokers. He tells them that he wants to purchase a bulk of 40 and sometimes 100 units of property to launder his employer's black money. After setting the scene for basic discussion about the property, he poses three questions. What is the percentage of the total value of the property that can be paid in illicit cash?
50-50.
How will the company ward off any trouble from income tax authorities arising out of this illegal transaction?
There will be any problem in registration?
No.
Can the company collect the cash amount in a different city or preferably outside the country? This intense investigation panning over several months across the nation brings out shocking revelations. The innovative means of ingesting black money into the companies offered by the senior-most officials of these companies are in gross violation of Income Tax Act, Foreign Exchange Management Act, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, and several other laws. And here are some of the shocking revelations of Operation Black Ninja. The ratio of black money involved in property deals in the real estate companies ranges from 10% to a whopping 90%. The black money transaction is not recorded anywhere. Sometimes it is put on paper as an informal agreement between the buyer and the seller, which is never declared. The sale price of the property is set to the mandatory minimum on paper. The stamp duty, which is the official tax owed to the government, is paid on that minimum rate declared on paper. The rest of the deal money is transacted in cash. Thus, the buyer is happy that he can launder his black money. The seller is happy that he saved on tax on the cash he has just earned. Thus, they become partners in crime. They register their properties at a certain price and declare the sale amount. Post the registration, the buyer submits another document listing out faulty construction, inadequate fittings and the like to reclaim a significant part of the money he spent on the property. After the seller returns the money in white, the buyer unofficially disburses the same amount back to the seller in cash. A maximum of 80% of the property sale amount is adjusted in cash and the property declared as a gift to the buyer. The purpose of the gift ranges from a birthday present to felicitating a freedom fighter patriarch. Plots are allotted to buyers even before the company gets the mandatory approvals and environment clearance. Some of these companies make arrangements for the cash component to be collected outside the country. Turns out, for these companies, hawala is business as usual. A number of senior officials of these real estate companies have confessed that they have conducted transactions in black money several times in the past. An extensive scrutiny of operations inside these real estate companies will reveal how these outfits are active agents of money laundering and cheat the income tax department of its rightful dues. While some of these tainted real estate companies, such as Alpine Housing Development Corporation Limited, are already listed on the stock exchange, others such as Lodha Developers have got SEBI's approval for their IPO but are yet to hit the market. According to a report by Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, the real estate sector is growing at a rate of 20% per annum and contributing nearly 6% to India's GDP. This sector has been further supported by the Indian government, which has now allowed FDI and NRI investment in real estate. With convenient banking and credit payment options, even an average salaried citizen can now afford a home. While certain metropolitan areas in the country flaunt a real estate price tag that supersedes those in Paris, other areas are poised to become India's very own Shanghai. A joint study by KPMG in India and National Real Estate Development Council shows that the size of the real estate sector is estimated to increase fivefold to reach $676 billion. Take a look at the financial corruption brewing inside these glossy exteriors of the Indian real estate industry. This is Operation Black Ninja.